Indeed, Chris. Coach, we were just talking about the fact that you were the first in your family to go to college. Now you got two kids at Harvard, one that's already graduated. How has being the head coach here changed your life?
Well, it's changed it in a lot of great ways. We have some amazing kids that we recruit, kids that end up being a part of their life for the rest of their life. And it's just an amazing institution, and it's hard to sort of articulate without being here, but it's just a great place to work. It's a great place to coach.
The guys were talking about the significance of this game. It seems a little bit different here because you have players that literally have gone on to do incredible things, like presidents, CEOs. How would you describe, amidst all that, the importance of this game?
Well, it's huge. I mean, to our kids, you know, to our players, our students, and our alumni on this day, it's just as important as the folks at Alabama and Auburn. We're not the SEC, but we're a Division I program where football is really important. It's just not the most important thing.
Chris talked about the health scare that you had back in February. Obviously, anytime someone goes through triple bypass surgery, that's a life changer. So how would you say it's changed your perspective as a coach?
Well, the irony is, in 28 years as a head coach, Sam, I'd never taken a sick day, literally. So I was the most surprised guy in the world. But it certainly makes you do a little soul searching, and it makes you realize the most important things in life are family, friends, and your health. But for me, it also made me realize how much I love coaching. And how much I especially love coaching these kids at this school.
We've been talking a lot this week about the money that is involved in this school, the endowment, over $30 billion. So that kind of begs the question. We've seen what Stanford has been able to do with their football program. Why has Harvard, at least not yet, chosen to plug all that kind of money into building that sort of powerhouse football school?
Well, I think you have to remember that Harvard and the Ivy League once were the Alabama and SEC of the day. And when they decided in 1956 to go away from that, it just comes down to prioritizing. And football is important here. And that's one of the reasons we've been fortunate to have a lot of success. And it's important in the Ivy League. But it's not the most important thing. And, you know, we're never going to compromise, you know, our core values. And that's not to say that, you know, the biggest conferences, the SEC, the Big 12, Pac-12, you know, they're very balanced as well, but obviously football there is a little bit more important to the school than it is here, even though it's still important.